All right, we want to welcome you back to Centralia College.
Next up, number five.
It is the sophomore night. The sophomores on Centralia are being celebrated. And let's look at some of those people that are sophomores. We have Ian Coates White, Landon Cout, Joshua Forster, Nashawn Henderson Cruz, Bryson Williams, and Spencer Gill. You know any of those?
I do not. Actually, I have interacted with Nashawn and Ian just a little bit. Acquaintance with them.
Yeah. I have had a few in my class. So all great athletes and great students. So as they honor them. Got their families here, the mothers and fathers. And so you always want to celebrate those people who committed for 2 years to play here at Centralia. If you can hear that on our, try to get that. Probably can't hear that very good, but they are talking about their future plans and what they want to do after they leave Centralia College. Many going on to four-year colleges. Some are going to play, I guess, and some are not going to play. But we're hearing a lot about master's degrees and some other things that they want to do. So who is this here? It's Bryson Williams from Wenatchee Valley.
Great thing that they're celebrating the loyalty, because coming to a junior college, sometimes it is a tough decision. You know, your friends are going off to 4 years, and you didn't get any offers to a 4-year or the chances you would have had at a 4-year to play. And you know, it's a good thing that these guys decided to choose this pathway, because junior college is very beneficial for a growing athlete like these guys, and they've definitely put in the work.
Yeah, and there are definitely stories of players who maybe when they were in high school, they didn't peak out yet,
right.
And then they really came to as they were in two-year college, went on to do some really good things.
Nice crowd here for this matchup. Tonight is the last game of the season for the Trailblazers. Coach Joe doing the announcing.
Yep.
Coach Joe is the stand-in AD.
And the new men's basketball coach, too. I believe he came from Tenino High School. He was, I think, athletic director there, and basketball coach there for a while, too. So, get ready for the game to start. There's 5 minutes up on the clock. I'm not sure where they have that up there. But with the men, again, it's 20-minute halves. So Coach Joe doing the announcements and gets to talk about his own players. So
yeah. Well, Coach Joe would know them best.
That's true.
As players.
Yeah. In his first year as a coach here. So I'm sure he'll be building up that the team as he recruits and gets to know more of the students in the area. And we do a lot of recruiting, actually. If we look at our roster, a lot of recruiting out of Utah, it seems like. I mean, for the last, as far as I can remember, for about the last 10, 15 years, we've been getting a lot of students, a lot of athletes out of Utah.
Yeah, that's interesting because I see that around all of the sports programs. I mean, I look at women's soccer, baseball. I mean, there's four to five players, from Utah.
Uh-huh.
And they seem to all know each other because I always see them hanging around each other. especially the baseball guys, but even the softball too.
Uh-huh.
So I think it's really interesting that Centralia is like kind of taking in these Utah players and with open arms, and it seems like some of the majority of the recruiting for all aspects of Centralia sports are coming out of Utah. So.
Yeah. Now, how many, are there a number of baseball players from Utah too?
Yes, there are. So my good friend Hudson Slack and Trey Jacobson, they're my roommates.
Uh-huh.
They're from Utah. And Trent Jones, he's also from Utah. Just to name a few. Justin Morgan, our sophomore ace, who's on the mound. He's a pitcher. He's from Utah as well. And his girlfriend and her sister are from Utah. So it's just a big line of people that they all know. They've all known each other. They're all a year apart or same year, whatnot, playing around the same time, same area. And I think it's really cool that they're all kind of joined back here.
So we have kind of a pipeline to Utah. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's good. We used to, I know at one point we got a lot of players from Alaska at one point, and I think there were some, we would get some from Arkansas and some places like that. So they have a big, you know, with the internet, you get a bigger database of recruiting.
Right.
And you get a couple players in, and they talk good about your program, and then get some more people coming over.
What surprises me the most is Nashawn Henderson Cruz, the sophomore guard from the Bronx. I mean,
well,
I don't, I mean, out of all these players, even the Alaska born players are really not that surprising to me, but to have an East Coast guy on a West Coast team, you don't see that too often in junior colleges.
Yeah. I wonder what the story is behind him coming here. And did his family move? Did he get recruited here? It'll be interesting to know. We'll have to talk to him.
All right.
Find out a little bit more about that.
Speaking of the sports teams, it seems to be women's soccer, baseball, softball are starting to show up, volleyball. We've got Coach Bauer and Coach Harley talking to Coach Joe on the sideline, both baseball coaches.
Soccer coach over there.
Yep.
So, yeah, right. Supported. There have been times where they've, you know, painted Centralia on their chest and sat in the front row and, you know, harassed the other team.
Yeah.
And, so they've always been really supportive. But it's good to see all the programs coming out.
Yeah, no, it's great. You know, baseball guys, we, you know, all of us have a lot of time. You know, a lot of time to spend. And when there's an open, you know, coaches are really mindful of it, too. Like today, we had a shorter practice. They're like, yeah, you need to go out, see the last game of the season. You know, we're giving you this time off to go celebrate another team. And I think that's really important
for
sports culture here.
Definitely. It's good to see that. I mean, you know, as a, especially, you know, as the athletes on campus, you know, you're a little bit different than the other students because you have more responsibilities. You got to go to practice and you got your classes.
Right.
And you're kind of a, you know, almost like a little select group of people. You can understand what the other athletes go through.
Right.
So it's just good to come out and support each other.
And, you know, it really helped me in my first year of college, you know, find a lot of friends because you almost have to be friends with them, right?
Yep.
You know, you quick 20, 30 friends right off the bat, you know, it makes college life a lot easier for sure.
Yeah. Now, hey, now, we have about a minute before the game starts. They're building, since you're on the baseball team, they're building the batting cages over here on the field. And they're putting a broadcast booth up at the top, so which is going to be nice. Do you know how you get up to that thing? Is there like a stairwell?
I've seen the stairwell. So
it's not a ladder,
stairwell.
Right?
No, not a ladder.
Okay, that's good to hear.
That would be cool, though.
I was wondering. It's kind of high up, but I'm like, are we climbing a ladder to get up there, or are we going to? Because I've been to a couple of high schools where the broadcast booth is on the top of the stadium, and you had a walk up, and on the roof you walk out across the roof, and the thing's shaking a little bit, and you're like,
it gets the energy up before you get in the broadcast booth.
Right. So, well, that'll be interesting this year, because last year trying to call baseball games was a little bit difficult. We were sitting behind the, to the side of home plate, and you couldn't see the count from the ref, and you're trying to describe the game, but you don't even know how many strikes and balls. It's a little difficult to do that.
Right.
All right, so we got about 10 minutes. Second game coming up. Pierce visiting. They've made the playoffs. And let's see, they are again, where are they? No, Pierce has not made the playoffs. They are at number 6th. just remember about maybe 10, 11 years ago, they won states.
So, something like that.
Yeah. All right, so here we go. They're doing the lineups for... Let's see if we can get the... So number 11, Cameron Williams. Number 13, Kaylin Allen. 22, Darius Henderson. Yeah, let's see who this is. 23,
Donnell Irving.
And who was the last one, the 25?
That would be Christian Bala.
Okay, Christian Bala. All right. Cruz. Number 5, Christian Coates. Ian Coates White. Brandon Coates. Last we have 22, Bryson Williams, and 34, Joshua Forrester. So there we have the lineups. And again, a little bit different. The women, both teams are in the playoffs, and both teams are having a tough season this year. So let's see, Pierce 5-8 right now, and Centralia is in seventh place behind Pierce at 3-11. It's a game really for pride and, trying to get that win over the team ahead of you.
All right, trying to get, end the season on a high note. You know, you don't want to remember the, 11 straight losses, especially on sophomore night. It seems like a packed house right now.
Yeah.
There's still people filing in here.
Spectators
and players from the women's basketball game still coming in.
Trying to get out of the rain, I think. Dude. But, there's a lot of people here. We hit the tip-off.
A jump ball. A little bit of fighting there by Ian Coates White. And immediately off the bat. Maybe Centralia ball. Already some roughhousing going on. Here's Nashawn bringing up the ball against Christian Bala. Nashawn to number 22, Bryson Williams. Bryson calling for the screen from Josh. Bryson to Nashawn. Nashawn for the deep three. Misses wide right. Ian Coates White comes off the ball. Nashawn again. Nashawn serving. Guarded by Cameron. Got that pass out of bounds. Bryson back to Nashawn in the corner. Nashawn guarded by Cameron. Cameron pokes the ball out. And that'll be Pierce ball. So I guess Nashawn tipped the ball right as it came out of his hands once Cameron kind of poked it out. Pierce has the ball. No score yet here. 19 minutes and some change. Here's Cameron. Gives up to Keelan. Keelan guarded by Josh, the sophomore. Previously celebrated tonight. Now Christian. To Donnell. Donnell with a deep two. They bring Pierce with it. Pierce strikes first against the Centralia Blazers. Nashawn trying to get something going here quick. Gives off to Bryson. Bryson on the left side of the court. Dumps off to Joshua in the post. Back up to number 21, back to Nashawn. And the corner three from Ian Coates White misses. And number 22, Darius, comes up with the ball. Here's number 23, Donnell, once again. Shoots the three, but misses this time. Now Nashawn, guarded by Christian Bala. Nashawn driving through the lane. Here's the floater. Drains that tie game from Nashawn here early. Coach Joe saying, keep the pace up. Being very animated as he is. Here's Cameron off to Darius. Darius, three-point line. Fakes the three-point shot. Here's Christian driving through the paint with the right-hand layup. Makes that one. So far, some quick work from Pierce here.
Yeah, they can keep this pace up the whole game? I'm not sure.
Right. It's, basketball is tough to keep a high pace up, but they seem to be doing a good job so far. Here's Ian. Here's a wide-open Landon Kaut misses. Josh Forrester tries to get the board, but Christian comes up with it. Now Cameron driving towards the paint. Attempts the pass. I believe that'll be Pierce ball.
Did you call a foul on somebody?
I believe so.
22. So that was on Bryson Williams.
Here's Christian with the ball on the three-point line. He dumps it off to number 23, Donnell, to Cameron, a three-point shot. He misses. A little end around in the rim. Nashawn calling for a screen. from Josh. Josh sets the screen. Double team by Keelan and Christian. He throws the pass to Ian. Ian to Bryson. Bryson to Deshaun. Contested three. He misses wide right again. Here's Joshua. Comes up with the board with a jumper. And he bangs it in. That's a tie game now. 4-4. 17-13. In the first quarter here. Here's Darius. Oh, a nice little contested layup there. Coach Joe telling Deshaun to get up the court quick. Keep setting the pace here. Here's Deshaun at the three-point line. He drives in. Gives it back off to Landon Kaut. Kaut to Ian. Ian with a three-point shot. Misses left. Darius to Cameron. Cameron, cross pass. Number 23, Donnell. Donnell misses that. Deshaun to Bryson. Bryson, full head of steam, passes off to Landon. Landon to Ian. Ian to Deshaun. Coach Joe yelling the play. Seems to be stagnant for now. Here comes the play here. Landon, a light screen there from Deshaun. Then Ian, Coach White, three-point line. Attempts the shot, gives it off to Deshaun. Deshaun guarded by Donnell. Ian guarded by Cameron. The three-pointer. This is wide.
Shot clock was down to two.
That was a close one. Here's number 24, Christian Ballaw. Keelan comes up with the board. Keelan misses that layup as well. Christian to Cameron. Cameron, the bounce pass, swatted away by Deshaun, and Landon Kaut comes up with the ball. He gives off to Bryson Williams up the right side of the court. Bryson Williams attempted three-point shot. Misses. Ian Coates White with the offensive board. Ian dumps it off to Landon. Landon and Deshaun. Stagnant here with Deshaun with the ball. Deshaun with a deep three. Bang. Misses left. Right. Number 23, Donnell Irvin, takes up the ball for Pierce. He attempts the three-point shot. Bang. That was a two-pointer. The deep two-pointer. His toes were on the line. So Pierce up 8-4. 15 minutes left. Here's Deshaun, guarded by Keelan. Deshaun gives it off to Bryson Williams. Bryson moves a corner three. Brings it within one. 15 is some change here. With a cross-court pass. Aaron, and it's out of bounds. Daniel Irvin got a little antsy there, tried to cherry pick the Centralia defense, but that did not end up happening.
So that pace was pretty quick in the first 5 minutes, so a lot of substitutes for Centralia. Try to sort that out as we go here.
So now Kevin Williams.
He's in.
Kevin Williams and Spencer Gill have subbed into the game. Deshaun with the ball, guarded by Cameron. There's Orion. And Orion Dibidal have subbed into the game. So three subs so far.
So we have a media timeout. I'm not sure what the media timeout would be.
Well, hopefully it's not us.
Yeah. So as we take this media timeout, first 5 minutes, very active players, a lot of running back and forth. And it's hard to keep up that pace, so we saw some substitutes come in. But Pierce up by 1 point, 8-7. Again, we're playing two 20-minute halves as opposed to the 10-minute quarters that the women play. So did you get a chance, halftime, to go look outside at all and see?
I did not know. I was exploring the concession stands, talking with my fellow teammates in the crowd. Did not get a chance. And to be frankly honest, I don't want to know yet. If it's raining, it's raining. As long as I get to my car stuck dry, I get to go home.
I was
going to
say, as long as your car's not stuck, you're okay.
It seems Pierce seems to be short-staffed on the player side. It almost seems like there's only one available sub for them.
Really? Yeah, you're right. That is weird. Let's see. One, two, three.
Now, I don't know if their players are sitting somewhere I can't see them, but there's only one guy on the bench right now.
Yeah.
Compared to the Centralia 9, 10.
Well, they have 15 players listed on the roster.
Right.
But we're only seeing six here. So I don't know what the deal is.
Spencer Gill with the ball. Gives off to Kevin. Kevin Williams with a deep three. Contested by number 20, Joshua Hardy. Jesh for short. Cameron with the ball. Gives it off to 22, Darius Henderson. Christian Ballaw guarded by Bryson Williams. Cameron with a two-point shot. The two-point jumpers. He made the two-point jumper, 10-7 Pierce. Here's Nashawn with the ball. Trying to cross over Cameron there. He gives it off to Spencer. Back to Nashawn, to Kevin. Kevin guarded by number 20, Jeshua. Kevin a 3.9. Nashawn driving towards Keelan. Pass off to Bryson Williams. Towards the Pierce bench to Nashawn at the top of the key, guarded by Darius. The ball's knocked out of bounds. That'll be Pierce ball.
So if Pierce does only have six, then you want to see a lot of substitutes. Oh, here comes another player. Is that another player that they have? Nope, just the one. You want to, if you're Centralia, you just want to wear them out. Keep running and substitute your players and keep some fresh legs in there and keep Pierce running up and down the court so you can wear them out.
All right. Yeah, it's an odd sight seeing as Cameron makes that two-point shot. Outside, only seeing one player on the bench. I've really never seen that before.
Yeah, that's really interesting.
Here's Kevin Williams with the ball. It's off to Bryson Williams. It's tipped out of. Oh, it almost got tipped out of bounds by Cameron. He passes up to number 20, Jeshua. Jeshua back to Cameron. Back to Donnell. He misses that shot. Rebound by Kevin Williams. Must be a foul on Centralia.
Who was the foul?
I'm
not seeing it up on the board yet.
Yeah, I'm not sure, but whatever it is, it was Pierce's ball.
Yeah, they didn't put it up on the scoreboard.
Just Christian. Christian gives it off to Cameron, back to Christian, up the baseline, but it's almost stolen by Spencer Gill.
So it would be Pierce's ball with 12 seconds on the shot clock.
All right. That was good effort by Spencer Gill, but he just couldn't get a right hand on it. And he kind of pushed it out of bounds. So it's now Pierce's ball, and ball heads out of bounds. Spectator tosses it back into the referee. So Pierce will take the ball, or excuse me, Centralia will take the ball. Kevin Williams taking the inbound pass, guarded by Jeshua Hardy. Sophomore guard out of Yelm. Kevin, an impressive point guard. Here's a Ryan Dibidall, another big man on this team. Bryson Williams, Riley, who is subbed into the game now. Tried to move a pass to Orion, but ended up getting kicked off by Christian Malah. Christian making some quick work in the paint. The and-one finish by Christian Malah. That was one heck of a finish by him. Almost like a reverse right-hand layup in traffic. And he ends up going
fouled
for the extra points. So here's a substitution here. So Riley's going to stay in the game, but Aaron B. Richards, number 33, and a very cool tattoo on the left calf will be entering the game now. And Spencer Gilbert gives it off to Kevin Williams. He's driving up the left side of the court, guarded by Christian Ballaw. Gives it off to Aaron B. Richards. Aaron drives through. Kevin at the seems to be Kevin actually stepped out of bounds there. Frustrated. Now there's a sub for Pierce. They bring out Christian and bring in Darius. And the ball is booted by number 23, Donnell Irvin. So that's a quick break for Centralia, who's down six. Eight. Wow, I can't count. There's Riley to Kevin. Kevin calling the plays now, guarded by Jeshua. Kevin driving to the right side of the court, looking for some work. Riley, the corner. Aaron B. Richards at the top of the key. Gives off to Spencer Gill, pump fakes. In the paint, gives off to Orion. Orion at the baseline, spin move, double teamed. Open Spencer Gill, missed a three-point shot at the buzzer. It's picked up by Keelan. Keelan to Cameron, excuse me. Darius, Donnell, back to Cameron. The right-handed layup, and he makes it. So Pierce now making quick work of Centralia. Up 10. A minute 43 to go.
Can they keep the pace up? That's the question, though.
Right. Keep the pace up with one guy on the bench. I believe there's probably going to be a lot of substitutions after this quarter. Centralia's got the depth. So I feel like that's the upper hand that Centralia has right now, even though they are down 10. Here's Riley at the corner. Gives off to Spencer Gill. Another attempt at three-pointer. Misses wide right. That'll be Pierce ball. Darius Henderson will give it off to Cameron, who's guarded by Aaron. Cameron pushing the ball up the court for Pierce. Some loud noise from the Centralia bench as Darius holds on to the ball, and there's a quick shot by number 23 on Pierce, Donnell Irvin. Picked up by Jeshua. Tries a little put back there, but picked up by Orion on the defensive board. Kevin bring up the ball, guarded by Jeshua. Get off to Aaron B. Richards, pump fakes the deep three, guarded by Darius. Oh, nice little quick move from Aaron. Kevin to open Spencer Gill once again. Bang!
This time he makes a
third time's a charm. Spencer Gill makes that three-pointer.
Plenty of time to get his feet set, get that shot off.
There's Cameron, gives it off to number 23, Donnell. Donnell to Darius. Darius in the paint, trying to make some work through traffic. Keelan comes up the offensive board. Orion, good defense by Orion, but seems to be a foul.
You can see some of the players and coaches contesting that foul. Looks like he went straight up.
Yeah. Well, it's so far a pretty physical game. Centralia, you know, they're taking the lead in fouls, unfortunately. But Keelan sinks that first one. A little bit of English.
Three team fouls on Centralia, none on Pierce so far, it looks like.
There's been a sub here. Deshaun is coming for Bryson. Keelan's second shot. Drains that one as well. So Deshaun will bring up the ball for the Trailblazers. Down nine. Deshaun guarded by Cameron. Orion's got the ball. Orion gives it off to Riley. Riley, full head of steam into the paint. Tries for the right-hand bank shot. Misses. 24, Christian Ballard bringing up the ball. Guarded by Spencer Gill. Cameron guarded by Deshaun. Cameron driving in. The pass to Christian. And the contested left-handed layup by Christian.
Could have been a foul.
Could have been. You know, but that was kind of a tough break for Centralia there. Down 11 so far early in this game. There's an errant pass. Christian picks up. There's Cameron with the two-point jumper. He misses that one. Spencer Gill comes down with the board. Deshaun drives up the left side of the court. Pass to Aaron B. Richards. Richards looking. Richards drives through. Keelan is there. Gives off to Riley. The right-handed layup. And now there's a timeout. Centralia. So that was a good pace pickup.
Yeah, especially what Centralia wants to do. Keep that pace up. Force Pierce to use up their energy, and they don't have any substitutes. So, well, they have the one substitute, and that's pretty much it. So, good strategy by Centralia to do that.
Right. They have the guys to wear out. So, right now, Pierce is up. But I would not be surprised if later in the game they start to struggle on pace.
Yep.
Maybe getting a little sloppy, and that's just purely by fatigue. So it's a really challenging task for Pierce here, but
definitely.
They're doing a great job so far.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be interesting when we get into that second half to see how their legs held up, because that starts to affect your shooting.
Right.
So it'll be interesting. And if Centralia just continues to push that pace and substitute a lot, we should see Pierce wearing down. I've seen this strategy like that before. When I was in high school, we had this coach who had this second team of five guys. He would substitute the whole team out, and for 5 minutes, those guys would run as hard as they could and try to cause a lot of chaos. And then he would substitute the other team, you know, the regular starters back in.
I'm not against that idea. That's pretty impressive by your coach to think of that. Pierce has the ball. Number 23, Donnell Irvin, guarded by Riley. Number two for Centralia. Riley playing some tough man defense here. Here's Jeshua. Let's make something happen. Double team. There's a travel by Jeshua. Tough double team on him, but you know, eventually he did travel. You got to keep that pivot foot down.
Yep. He looked a little shocked there, but the truth was he did move his foot.
Right. Here's Deshaun. Deshaun going to make work against Jeshua. Here's Aaron B. Richards driving up for the right-handed layup.
Scooped
in
it up
traffic.
Yeah, a nice little scoop shot there.
know, Aaron's a good player. He's a very scrappy player. I remember one game he made about three threes in a row. And there's Keelan with a three-point shot on the left-hand side of the court. Impressive by the big man. But Aaron's a good three-point shooter. He plays hard. And he's a good asset off the bench for this team. Here's Nashawn. There must be a foul on the court here. You know, Aaron's story is really interesting. He's almost redshirted, but he said, you know, coach, I just really want to try out for the team. I really want to make a difference for the team, and he got better and he got better. And now you see him playing here in some meaningful minutes.
Yeah.
You know, down a few. And he's now taking the ball up for Centralia, so a really inspiring story.
Yeah. Shows you what you can do if you're persistent and don't give up.
Here's Nashawn for the corner three. Bangs out of there. That was a quick pass by Keelan to number 23. The almost oop pass by Christian Ballaw. Now Aaron B. Richards taking up the ball with a deep three. Bang! Aaron B. Richards. Coach Joe's pumping his fist, pumped up for the young Aaron. That was a timeout. That three-pointer came in handy. If he missed that, then I'd look like a fool, wouldn't I?
Yeah. So if I'm Pierce, those fast breaks, every time I'm running those, I'm thinking, we better get points off of this.
Oh, yeah. You know, Aaron, I mean, unless Aaron gives another heat check, but basically Aaron's telling him, hey, step up. You know, I'm here. I'm a presence. So.
Yep. So, yeah, pretty quick pace game so far, 23-17. Got 7:58 left in this first half. And Pierce is really, you know, you got to pace yourself. I mean, you're going to have to do those fast breaks when you get a chance, of course. But you better come away with points, because that can get frustrating.
So Bryson, Ian, and Joshua sub in for the Trailblazers. Joshua is taken out for Pierce, the lone sub. Here's Cameron against Bryson. Keelan, three-point line guarded by Joshua. Keelan looking for an open guy. Calling plays. Joshua playing some hard defense, the big man. Darius with the ball. Hands it back off to number 24, Christian. Ian Coates White with some tough defense. Joshua ends up with the ball. There's a foul.
Yep. Looks like someone reached in.
That's a foul on Ian. You know, getting a little rough there, getting a little antsy. That's okay. You need a high energy, but we got to be disciplined as well.
This is first foul, fourth team foul.
Cameron will try to make some quick work against Bryson. Here's Keelan against Joshua. A little stutter step there. Dumps it off to Christian Ballaw. Nashawn takes the fake, but Keelan misses the layup. That'll be Centralia ball. They're trying to make something happen too quick there.
Pierce with the substitute. It's going to be interesting how they manage the substitutions here.
Right.
For Pierce.
So it's almost 30 seconds. After every 30 seconds, there's a new guy coming in here. And here's Nashawn. He gives off to Aaron B. Richards. Aaron B. Richards, a quick three-point shot. He misses short. Christian Ballaw comes up with the defensive board. Cameron jumps off to Darius. Darius trying to work against Joshua Forrester here, the sophomore. Darius, double teamed by Aaron B. Richards. B. Richards comes up with the ball. And the ref does call a, can't see the call from here, but seems to be, it's Pierce ball. Excuse me. Our viewing here is limited.
Yeah, definitely is.
Here's Christian Ballaw. Comes off to Donnell. Donnell with the errant pass to Joshua, but he picks it up quick before Ian could get his hands on it. Here's Joshua driving to the lane. Joshua to an open Cameron and a deep three. Swings out of there. Ian Coates White with the defensive board. Here's Nashawn coming up with the ball. He passed off to Aaron B. Richards with another three-point shot, and he misses. And Donnell comes up with the ball. Donnell Irvin to number 22, Darius. Almost a reverse lay, almost makes it in, but in comes White. Another rebound. Bryson Williams to Aaron. Nashawn with the three-pointer. Bang! Nashawn brings the lead within, or the deficit within three. 6 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Here's Cameron, guarded by Bryson. Cameron trying to get some quick work in here. Cameron with a two-point jumper, misses, short. Aaron B. Richards comes up with the ball, passes off to Nashawn. Nashawn driving up the right side of the court. Guarded by Cameron, the deep three-pointer by Nashawn. He misses wide right. Seems to be his miss tonight. Here's Darius, full head of steam against Aaron B. Richards in the paint. Here's a Euro step and the lay. Brings the lead within five
pretty
for Pierce.
Athletic play. Still pushing the ball up the court quite a bit.
100%. They're doing a good job of, management of the ball. Unlike Centralia, but here's Jeshua with the left-handed lay. Pierce is now within a seven-point gap from Centralia. Bryson trying to slow things down for the Centralia offense. Trying to get a play going here, so he chip away at this lead. Oh, there's a little backhanded pass to Ian Coates-White, the three-point shot. He misses left. Bryce Williams with the board again. Aaron B. Richards saying step up, but he drives in a little right-hand floater, and he makes it. So now the deficit at five. 4 minutes, 50 to go. First quarter. Here's Darius bringing up the ball against Joshua Forrester. And Jeshua to Nashawn. The ball almost comes out of bounds right into my hands. Number 23, Donnell, guarded by Ian Coates-White. And the contested three, and he missed that three. The student section goes wild, heckling the sophomore Donnell Urban.
It'll be a foul on Pierce.
Here's a timeout.
He's at 20 on Pierce. Hardy gets that foul, reaching in foul. So, yeah, that was on Hardy, number 20, so reach in on them. So when we come back, Centralia should have the ball. So Pierce, wow, it's hard to believe they only have six players.
Right.
But they've got to make do, and that becomes a challenge for them. But, 15 listed on the roster. You wonder where the other nine are. Is there maybe there's a flu going around or something? We don't know the story on that.
Yeah, I feel like it's really easy for sports teams at close quarters, to get a flu. I remember the baseball team. There's a weird case of hand, foot, and mouth going around for 2-3 weeks, and guys were just in and out, and it's tough. But to lose that many guys, that's
pretty tough.
That's doesn't seem like coincidence. So
yeah. So is there? That would be interesting to find out. Definitely.
We may bring you that information after the half, if we can find that, but so far we speculate, and we look on to that six-man team that Pierce has got going on so far. Here's Kevin Williams, shifty point guard. He gives off to Spencer Gill, Landon Kaut, sophomore. Aaron B. Richards, a little end around, but Pierce ball.
What the call was there.
I wonder if that was an illegal screen.
Yeah, they called a foul at 21.
Yeah. Seems he was setting up a screen for Aaron, and maybe he was moving his feet a little too much for the ref's liking. So that'll be Pierce's ball regardless. But Cameron guarded by Kevin Williams. Gives off to Jeshua, guarded by Nashawn out of the Bronx. Here's Keelan. Hard defense from Landon Kaut. There's Christian Balak coming in. Jeshua with the corner three. Misses wide right. With the student section heckling.
Is it going to be on Kevin Williams? Who was that foul on? Let's see. 33.
Was yeah, that 30. Was Aaron B. Richards.
That's his first.
Yep. Joshua inbound the ball. Cameron. Trying to make quick work against Spencer Gill. Calling for Joshua to move over on the baseline, but Cameron being double teamed. Really tough play in. Over the other half of the court.
Over
the Centralia ball. Now Centralia playing tough defense on that play.
Yeah.
Really trying to tire them out early. So when they come back from half, they're a little more, disoriented.
Yeah, just under 350 left in this first half.
All right. Here's Nashawn, guarded by Christian. Yeah, Kevin Williams and Jeshua. Kevin Williams drives towards the baseline. The right-handed floater misses. Keelan comes off the ball. Oh, but it's stolen by Leyden. Kevin, the right-hand layup. Brings it within three for Centralia. Oh, and another steal by Spencer Gill. He shoots it out of bounds.
Just down by three now.
Hitting one of the volleyball players in the stands, very close to the court. He's number 20, he dumps it off to Darius. Darius at half court, guarded by Landon Cout. Darius with the open three, now a contested three. Landon Cout misses that to the right. Spencer Gill gives off to Nashawn. Nashawn bringing the ball up for Centralia. He drives through the lane. Just a little spin move and the right-handed layup, and he misses. So that would be a foul. Number 22, Darius. And Nashawn will go to the three-point line for his attempted 2 points.
So blocking foul, and who was that on?
That was on
24.
Darius.
24. Okay.
Or that was on
Christian
that was on Darius Henderson. Riley Mickelraith will come in for Aaron B. Richards here. Riley, a freshman guard out of Edenville, Washington. And Centralia cutting their lead, they're cutting their deficit down to two.
Yeah.
And Jeshua got subbed out. There's a board by Christian. Cameras bring up the ball, guarded by Kevin. And that double team, but the ball is out. On Pierce. Will be given to Centralia. Now Bryson Williams will be coming in for Kevin. This gives you this be Pierce's ball. So Darius inbounds with number 24, Christian Beloved. Cameron, number 11 for Pierce, guarded by Bryson Williams. Cameron at half court. Tough defense by Spencer Gill and Bryson. Give it back to Cameron. Cameron drives through the lane. Almost a triple team there. Darius attempts the dunk, but he misses. Hard defense in the paint. Coach Joe arguing with the ref about the call. His hands on his head, eyes wide open.
So they're going to call Landon Cout maybe on that one.
Yeah, he was very surprised on what the call was on there. Seems Joe is very, very against what the referees called there. But regardless, Darius Henderson will show up to the free throw line.
Who'd they call that on? They call that Riley
Mickelraith?
Mickelraith, yeah. Easy for you to say.
Well, I don't even know if I'm pronouncing it right, but I feel like that's it's either that or McLareth.
Yeah.
It'd be nice to ask him, but currently he's standing and waiting for a rebound. So.
That's right. Try to get his attention as he runs by.
Yeah. Here's Riley, the man of the hour. Here's Nashawn, but back to Bryson Williams. Back to Nashawn, guarded by Cameron for Pierce. Nashawn gets the screen, but double teamed by Keelan and Cameron. Sean to Bryson. Bryson to Spencer. Spencer pump fakes the 3-point shot. A bounce pass to Riley. Almost out of bounds. And he keeps it in play for Centralia Blazers. And Riley with a corner three. Bang!
That brings him to 1 point. He's down by one.
Riley with a crucial three. Bring the deficit within one. Now Cameron guarded by Bryson Williams. This man defense is doing some work against the short-staffed Pierce team. 23, Donnell gives off to Cameron, back to Keelan. Keelan gives it away to Riley. Riley's going to bring up the ball towards Nashawn. Nashawn, three-point line, looking for some work. He's guarded by Donnell. Riley, the three-pointer, misses left. Spencer Gill almost with the board, but comes up with Landon Cout. Spencer Gill with a three-point shot. Bang! He banks it in. Centralia with the lead, first lead of the night, with 1 minute, 30 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Now Cameron gives it off to Donnell. Donnell with the open three, bang! Makes that shot, brings it to a tie. Coach Joe calling a play, flexing his fist. Must be the play call. Nashawn gives the ball off to Spencer Gill. Nashawn running through the post. Spencer Gill trying to find some work. Here's Riley at the three-point line. Back to Nashawn. Guarded by Cameron. Deep three. Misses wide. Air ball. Give it off to Christian Ballard, but it's blocked. No problem for Darius Henderson. To Donnell. Darius Henderson with the open three. Bang! Rattles in there for a three-point lead. With 45 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Now Nashawn brings up the ball. Dumps off to Bryson. Bryson driving through the lane. He gives it off to Riley. Riley having some tough time handling the ball, but Cameron comes up with it for Pierce. Pierce has the ball. Christian dribbles it off of his foot, and that'll be Centralia ball.
Just over 30 seconds left in this first half.
Some substitutions made. Aaron being shoved out there by Coach Joe. Coach Joe eager for Aaron to get out there for the last 30 seconds. Oh, Kevin Williams, and no, he's getting the ball. Kevin Williams coming up the court. Gives off to Nashawn. Nashawn gives off to Bryson Williams. A lot of guys on the perimeter right now. Not a lot of play going on here. Kevin
seconds.
Calling the play. His thumbs in the air.
Shot clock is pretty much the same.
Trying to shake Christian. He gives it off to Landon Cout, guarded by Keelan. Gives off to Nashawn. Keelan switches.
6 seconds.
Here's Kevin with a deep three, and he misses. And Christian Malak of the ball, and Cameron with the hope and a prayer. But Pierce is ahead by three in the first quarter.
31-34, Pierce with the lead. Centralia able to whittle that down, though, and got really close.
100%.
So, but the pace was pretty fast in this first half. And Pierce only with one substitute. It'll be interesting to see strategy in the second half. So, if you're Centralia, you really wanted to come away with maybe a lead at the end of the first half to put more pressure on Pierce.
Right. It seems Pierce seems to be getting a little tired. But they're still scoring at a pretty alarming rate.
Yeah. I think what'll tell the story is how tired their legs get in the second half.
Right.
And whether their shots are going to connect or not.
Yeah, and it seems like all these guys around the same height. I mean, the shortest player that's playing right now is Cameron Williams at 6 foot. But he is a sophomore. He's got that experience. And all these guys are almost interchangeable, really, in roles. So that makes it more flexible. Mm-hmm. You're not trying to play a center of the guard position, right?
Right.
All these guys are around 6'2", 6'4". Like I said, Cameron at 6 foot. But so far, Pierce has been handling it surprisingly well.
Yeah, they look very athletic.
Right.
And I think if you're a player, you're going, hey, we can weather this storm, but we'll see, in the second half when it gets down to about 7 minutes left, how they're doing at that point. But we're going to take a break then and try to get some stats, maybe find out the reason that Pierce only has 6 players on their team tonight when they have 15 listed.
Right.
I don't know if anybody over on the other side would know, but maybe we'll sneak over there and see if we can find out. So we'll be gone for about 10 minutes. We'll be back with the second half of tonight's game. It's halftime, and Pierce has a lead, 34-31. Again, coming into the game, as far as the playoffs and stuff, neither team is going to make the playoffs. Pierce comes in at 6th place with a 5-8 record, and in 7th place is Centralia. We're at 3-11. And have lost 11 in a row, so they really want to get this win tonight. We want to end the season on a good note here. All right, we'll be back in about 10 minutes. All right, we want to welcome you back to Centralia College, the Watterson Court in the Michael Smith Gymnasium. We have the second game of the doubleheader. The Centralia Trailblazers has taken on the Pierce Raiders of Pierce College. We're at halftime right now. We've got about less than a minute before the second half starts. Score is Pierce up 34-31. And I think the story of the game is that Pierce only has six players that they've brought here. And so Centralia, talking about the maybe strategy of trying to wear them down, they really kept the ball moving pretty fast pace in the first half. And we'll see how that affects Pierce in the second half, whether they start to tire out or not.
I ran into one of the players in the hallway. Pretty sure it was Christian Bala. I couldn't see his jersey. And I asked him quickly, like, why are there only six guys on the team? And supposedly there had been some disciplinary reasons to why guys didn't come. Lack of focus is what he said. So they're, you know, coach made the decision, like, hey, these six guys, they'll win us the game because they are always going to be locked in. And who knows if that's a smart move or, you know, a questionable move by the coach. But so far, seems to be working just fine for him.
Right. Yeah, you would want maybe to bring an extra couple players just to give him a rest.
Right. But seems to be one is enough so far.
Yeah.
Another main point here is, you know, Pierce is 1-for-10 in the field from 3 points.
It's hard to believe.
I know. And, you know, Centralia's made 6 of their 25. So, in reality, they're kind of the same differential.
Yeah. But it seems like Pierce made more than just one. But maybe they took a couple long twos, I think.
I do remember a long two mixed in there. Here's Keelan. Guarded by Joshua Forrester, and he airballs that. Got the putback. Try it again. That'll be Pierce ball.
They'll call a foul. Looks like on 34, maybe. Let's see what they put up there.
Foul on Joshua Forrester.
Who are they calling? 33? They have it up on 33. But I don't think he's even in. No, there he is right there.
Aaron B. Richards at half court.
Okay, yep. Well, I guess they called it on him then.
And B. Richards has
Two fouls. Only a second, so not too bad.
Right.
Kevin Williams in the game for Centralia.
Kevin Williams gives off to Nashawn. Goes out to Orion with a left-hand lay. Centralia chipping away here. Cameron gives it off to number 23, Dunno Irvin. No Cameron. Keelan. Keelan guarded by Joshua. Darius. Back to Darius. What a beautiful pass by Donnell Irvin to Darius in the paint, through the lane. Now Kevin Williams will bring up the ball for Centralia. A little fancy little pass there to Joshua Forster from Kevin. There's Nashawn, guarded by Cameron. Kevin Williams, a three-point line, gives off to Joshua Forster, making some work. Keelan misses the jumper. Turnaround jumper. Christian Bullock comes up the ball. Gives off to Cameron, guarded by Kevin. Cameron dumps off to Christian Ballard. Christian Ballard blocked by Orion Dibidol.
Looked like he got mostly ball, but he must have got part of his hand.
He must have.
So he thought, he's still looking at the ref like, what?
Coach Joe yelling, hey man, that's basketball. If I were to put that in quotes. Very likely of Joe to be this energetic in a game. Energetic guy. Great guy. Very passionate about the game of basketball and his team. He always will be. Teams all around as well.
39-33 after that free throw. And now 40, so a 7-point lead for Pierce.
So Kevin takes up the ball. Some traffic here, backcourt in Pierce territory as Kevin brings up the ball, guarded by Christian Bala. Orion gets stripped away. That pass is stolen from Kevin Williams and the right-handed lay by Darius Henderson. Now the lead, 42-33, Pierce. Here's Kevin driving through the lane, bumped by Christian. Now two heavy collisions by some big guys against a smaller player, Kevin. You know, good for Kevin to kind of dig his nose in there.
24.
Take the contact.
Second. Yeah. And it's a second foul on number 24.
All right.
Who would be Christian Bala.
Kevin makes that one.
Kevin, a pretty good free throw shooter, too. I don't have his stats here, but I remember watching him. And seems to be on the higher end of the free throw percentage for the team.
Yeah, I mean, so Pierce has only gotten so many chances at the free throw line, but they're 100% from free. Centralia is 50%. Here's Darius Henderson, guarded by Joshua Forrester. He gives it off to Keelan in the post. Guarded by Orion. Orion pushes him back out to the perimeter, giving to Cameron, guarded by Kevin. Cameron, turnaround jumper, misses. Aaron B. Richards gives it off to Kevin Williams. Quick pass. Kevin Williams looks to Aaron B. Richards in the corner. Raise the threes up on the sideline. He misses. It's 23, Donnell Irvin coming off the bench for Jeshua. There's Keelan. Oh, and the pass gets stolen by,
Forrester, I believe.
Forrester. And it rims around. And Centralia, 37-42. Cameron brings up the ball, guarded by Aaron Richards. Keelan, guarded by Forrester. And Donnell, with the turnaround shot, misses for the Lions. Now Nashawn is in the game for Centralia. He gives it off to Aaron B. Richards. He attempts the three. Nice little pass to Joshua Forrester, but it's knocked out of bounds by Orion Dibidol. Good pass by Aaron B. Richards, but I don't know if Joshua was ready for it.
A little bit behind the back bounce pass.
Yeah.
So I think you're probably not ready for that most of the time, but
yeah.
It was a good pass.
Darius Henderson here on the Centralia sideline. Dumps it off to Cameron, guarded by Kevin Williams. Oh, Cameron, the long pass to Darius, gives it off to Jeshua. Donnell's on the sideline now. That'll be a foul.
Number 23, is that? Yep, 23 for us. That'll be his third foul.
Now Jeshua is in the game. Cameron guarded heavily by Kevin Williams. Screen by Keelan fails, but Keelan at the perimeter passes back off to Christian. Christian surveying the field, gives off to Cameron. Cameron in traffic, gives off to Keelan. Jeshua guarded by Nashawn, tripped up. Nashawn playing some incredible defense there. And Orion is almost at the buzzer. Cameron misses that shot from three. 37-42 Blazers. Nashawn, errant pass. I believe that is one of his many turnovers this game so far.
Missed the shot and gets a rebound.
Here's Nashawn with the ball. That will be a jump.
Forrester looks like he's hurt his foot. So see if they get Forrester out.
Doesn't look like it.
Yeah, there it is.
So Bryson Williams and Landon Cott, or Couch, excuse me, into the game. Nashawn gives it off to Kevin. Kevin calling the plays here. Darius stops Kevin in his tracks. Aaron B. Richards picked up by Darius and Cameron. Gives off to Kevin, who's a wide open Kevin. Attempts the two-point shot. Gives off to Bryson. Bryson to Nashawn. Give it back to Bryson. Bryson at the three-point line. Gives off to Aaron B. Richards at the three-point line. And he misses the contested three that he would make so many times. But Donnell Irvin. Bang! That's a good shot by Donnell Irvin. He gives a kiss to the crowd. Playing around with the student section here. It's Kevin to Aaron B. Richards, the two-pointer. And Aaron makes that one. A little bit of English. It's 39-45 Blazers. 6-point deficit, but nothing they can't handle with 15 and some change to go. Here's Donnell guarded by Nashawn and Darius guarded by Kaut. Here's Darius driving through the lane. A spin move. Right-handed lay. That was a beautiful move by Darius. And there's a timeout by Pierce. Giving them a breather. maybe they desperately need.
A couple substitutions coming in, too. But Darius Henderson, really athletic out there for Pierce and really carrying that team. And I remember watching him, I think, last year. He's a sophomore this year. They're very athletic, and they see the leading scorer. At the half, he was leading scorer for them.
With nine, yeah.
Yeah. But he's been very active tonight. So Centralia is still pushing that pace, trying to wear down Pierce. See if that works, that strategy works. There's 15 minutes left. Pierce still maintaining a pretty good lead, though.
You know, Pierce, you know, the coaches seem to have picked the six guys that, you know, would help them win, and it shows.
Making that statement to the other players, hey, you know, we can win without you.
Right.
So.
Yeah, it's unfortunate what they had to do with the rest of the team, but it really seems like they're not having that much trouble. This seems to be the six main guys that they want on the court at all times, and they're certainly exercising them for sure. So this will be a tougher game for them, but they're so far just dominating and doing a great job of the short staff.
Doesn't seem to have affected them so far.
Here's Riley to Kevin. Riley's in the game now. Kevin guarded by Cameron. Kevin brings the ball from the left side of the court. He's calling Bryson over for the screen, maybe. And he's psyched the screen out to Riley, back to Kevin, back to Bryson. Bryson guarded by Donnell. Donnell giving Bryson some trouble there. Here's Kevin guarded by Cameron in the lane, right-hand lay. Good layup by Kevin Williams, sticking his nose in there, being shifty as usual. Here's number 20, Jeshua. Gives off to Christian Bala, and the open Cameron. Misses short. And Kevin Williams sticking his nose in there for the ball once again. Cameron trying to call the plays here. Aaron B. Richards driving up the baseline. He gives it off to Bryson, and that'll be a blocking foul. So Aaron B. Richards will visit the free throw line.
Jeshua Hardy.
Oh, excuse me, there's a timeout.
Blocking foul. So short timeout. 14:23 left in the second half here in the game, and it's 47-41, Pierce in the lead. Pierce coach, one of the coaches from Pierce, asking about maybe the way he's calling the game. Looks like they're just having a friendly conversation out there, so nothing heated. But it is a timeout here, and again, Pierce probably appreciating these timeouts to get 100%. That little rest.
I couldn't imagine running out there for that long, knowing there's only one sub. And
yeah, I just think maybe psychologically, when thinking, we look ahead of the game and you go, we gotta pace ourselves.
You know, I believe there's two different ways you could look at it. So you could be timid about it, saying, oh, I might get tired, and you know, there's not that many subs, so I'll have to stay out there. Or you could kind of just put your nose to the grindstone, and you're like, I'm the guy for this amount of time. And
well, I think what helps them, too, is they have the lead. Now, if they were down by 20, I think it would be a whole different story.
100%. So. Right now, I think they're coasting.
Yeah.
Is what you'd call it. So. Here's Nashawn. Ready to inbound the pass to someone who's open. Here's Bryson Williams. Finally gets the ball off. Guarded by Christian. And shot is blocked by Christian Bala. What a block. Now Christian Bala is calling up Cameron. And Cameron looking at his coach for the play. Calling rip, rip, rip. Cameron at the baseline. Gives off to Keelan. Keelan with the two-pointer. Bang.
Yeah, you know, as long as you have that lead, you're going to be energized.
Now Bryson gives off to Kaut. Kaut guarded by Keelan. Just made that two-pointer. Bryson, the bounce pass out of bounds.
Sort of fancy behind the back bounce pass.
Yeah, if Coach Joe was playing, that would have been a good pass.
Yeah. But, it's a substitution.
Yeah, I think getting too fancy in this scenario 100% costs you. But you know, he had the right idea of passing to the right guy. The execution, though, was questionable. Here's Cameron, guarded by Aaron B. Richards. Play's getting called. Jeshua to the perimeter. Keelan to the perimeter. Guarded by Cow. Double team on Cameron. Tough break for Cameron there. Jeshua guarded by Nashawn. And that's Coach Joe yelling at a silent gym.
You're calling a foul?
And it's a foul on Deshaun.
Deshaun, that's his second, it looks like. Well, they haven't put it up there, but.
That would be his second, I believe.
They're putting it up.
So Cameron's got the ball. Riley's in the game now. Riley, quick screen by Keelan at the two-pointer. And Cameron misses. And Spencer Gill as well joins the party. Now Deshaun brings up the ball. Christian bringing it up with him. Jeshua's on him. Aaron B. Richards against Donnell. Aaron B. Richards with the right-handed layup. He misses. Oh, hookshot-esque. There's Donnell with the ball. Donnell being guarded by Aaron B. Richards and Cout. Now Jeshua to Cameron. Back to Donnell with a deep three. Bang! That is one heck of a shot by Donnell, and he's smiling. Now Deshaun gives it off to Riley. Riley with the right-hand leg gets blocked by Cameron. Cameron dumps it off back to Jeshua. Now Jeshua, misses the right-hand lay.
We'll call a block foul on Cout there.
Yep.
But 11-point lead now for Pierce. So 12:42 left in the game. Yeah, the 15 foul, and he's at the line.
Jeshua, the attempt. He makes that one. Has some subs here. And Joshua Forrester comes in for the Blazers, replacing Landon Cout. Jeshua's second shot. Makes that one as well. Now they're trying to get off to a quick pace here as Joshua goes to the baseline real quick here. Now here's Deshaun guarded by Darius. Darius playing some hard D against him. And here's Spencer Gill to snag that quick pass. And here's Ambry Richards. He tented the three-point. A nice pump fake. A two-jumper. Now Joshua Forrester with the right-handed layup. It's a nice pass by Aaron B. Richards, knowing he couldn't get that shot off, so he dumped it right off to Joshua Forrester, allowing for those points to be accounted for. So here's Keelan. Keelan having some trouble against Spencer Gill. Spencer Gill. Oh, but Keelan has no problem with the double team of Joshua Forrester and Spencer Gill.
13-point lead for Pierce.
Now Riley bringing the ball up against Christian. Riley in around, surveying the perimeter. Aaron B. Richards with a deep three, and he misses wide. And that'll come up to Pierce, to Centralia's ball. Keelan tips it out of bounds. Kevin Williams comes in for Riley McElraith.
Pierce making substitute two. 24 coming out.
Here's Kevin. Gives off to Aaron B. Richards. Richards to Deshaun. Deshaun surveying the perimeter. He drives in the lane. A little Kyrie-esque. He cradles the ball. Right-hand lay. Here's Darius being guarded by Spencer Gill. He loses the ball right into Kevin Williams' hands. And he dumps it off to Spencer Gill with the right-handed lay. He misses high. Cameron to number 23, Donnell Irvin. He just sinks that three.
59-45.
Letting the student section know that he can hear him, but he's not paying attention. Here's Kevin Williams, number three for Centralia. Gives it off to Joshua Forrester. Back to Aaron B. Richards in the corner, the three-point specialist. He drives through the lane. The right-handed reverse layup. And I believe that will be a Centralia ball. Coach Joe yelling, settle. Telling the team to slow down. Settle into themselves. Hold your water. Another expression for that. Here's another right-handed layup by Aaron B. Richards. The putback. Now, Centralia only down by 12 now. And the clock is frozen at 10:55. And they just restarted the clock now, so some time was granted to Pierce.
They'll call it on Forrester, it looks like.
Darius.
Forrester, yeah, 34.
Visiting the line once again.
It'll be Forrester's first?
Second, I believe.
When they have just one up on the board. But
just one up on the board?
I think it is second.
I thought he had another one.
I did too.
But I guess it is his first.
So 60-47. Despite just having six players who are playing, Pierce is doing a great job out there. Got about 10, almost 11 minutes left. They don't seem to be tiring out that much.
Not at all. Now they're up, 61-47. 10:49 to go. The clock is being extra slow. And I'm confused on what the call is here.
Yeah.
Here's Kevin Williams and Jeshua. Airby Richards takes a high pass, guarded by Christian. Oh, and he tried to bring it through the legs, but he couldn't. The crossover did not work against Christian. Now Kevin faking. Now it's a travel by Kevin Williams. And a tiny celebration by Pierce. Centralia is struggling right now, primarily just to get a playoff. The scoring has not been in favor of them, and their defense so far has been shown to be, you know, quite all right. It's just Pierce is outscoring him. For example, Kevin Williams with that steal, and he passes over to Spencer Gill, but that's the problem right there. They tend to just get a little antsy. And guys like Darius, who have a long reach, they tend to notice that, and they just stick their hand out as soon as they see the ball. And it's smarter to keep the ball on the ground, I believe. Now, Nashawn with the right-handed floater misses. Christian Balaw comes up with the ball. Back to Cameron, to Christian. The Euro step brings that to Donnell. Donnell to Cameron, saves the ball. Back to Christian in the lane. Now, that was one heck of a sequence.
Yeah, good ball movement by Pierce.
And unfortunately, Centralia had to endure that. Coach Joe frustrated.
Do we have a timeout? And 9:48 left, first half. Pierce, yeah, good ball movement, made all the right decisions on that last sequence there.
Right.
But they are up 65-47.
You know, it seems that Centralia is beating themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that's why that's the most of the frustration that's coming from Coach Joe and the players, that they know that they're beating themselves. They're letting a six-man team, you know, give them a run for their money. Now, they have plenty of time to come back. I've seen comebacks like this before, but so far it is looking very very glim for the Centralia Blazers. So.
Yeah, Centralia has lost 11 in a row, and now they're faced with a six-man team. You don't really want to lose this. You want to get this victory. Trying to wear them down, but Pierce seems to be able to weather the storm. So, that, you know, if the coaches decided to just bring six people, they brought the right six people. They right. know what they're doing.
And you know what? They don't look tired one bit.
No.
Which is, which comes to a surprise. Nashawn brings up the ball. Riley's in the game now, along with Ian Coates White. Ian's got the ball, brings it off to Riley. Riley dumps it off to Joshua, whose layup was blocked by Darius Henderson. But that was a foul.
Yeah, they called a foul.
They called a foul on him, which Darius loves the competition. He's laughing. He's chirping the student section, it looks like. Student section being very loud.
It, you know, there have been a couple questionable calls, but that's going to happen. They even out during the game. But it looked like he didn't. I don't know if that was an actual foul or not.
You know, maybe he just got a little bit too much of his body onto Joshua. Both have missed. So the ball now in Pierce's hands. Christian Balaw taking the ball up. Full head of steam, the left-handed layup. Joshua tries to have him take a charge, but fails. Here's Nashawn, half court, trying to call the plays. There's a screen on Cameron. It's been a legal screen on Centralia, so now it'll be Pierce ball. Landon Cow getting ready for the sub. Attacking his shoes. There's Cameron, got it by Riley. And Aaron B. Richard steals the ball away from Christian Ballaw, but that's just out of reach of Riley Mikkelraith. Cameron's got the ball. He dumps off to a wide open Donnell Irvin. He misses that three-pointer. Now Riley's got the defensive board. And now Deshaun.
Seems like Centralia has missed a lot of those easy opportunities coming down just a little bit off on those passes.
100%. Aaron pass by Deshaun. Trying to make something happen with Joshua Forrester, but it's taken back by Darius Henderson and the lay. Seems to be a wet spot on the court.
So it'll be a timeout here as they mop that up. 69-47, Pierce with the lead. We've got about 8:45 left in the game. And, yeah, Centralia has these opportunities, but just errant passes like that last one. I don't know if it was the best pass decision to make, but that's what's costing the game right now is just some decisions where they might want to be a little more conservative.
Yeah, Pierce is playing a lot of hardball right now. Defensive heavy. It seems Darius Henderson is shaken up a little bit. Frustrated even. I don't know. I'm mistaken. He's just fired up. So here's Deshaun. He gives off to Ian Coates White at the perimeter. Riley takes the ball up, guarded by Donnell. Deshaun, the deep contested three. He misses. Aaron B. Richards tries for the board. But it'll end up Centralia ball due to Christian Ballaw knocking out of bounds. So now, let Riley take the ball up here. Looking for the inbound pass. Darius subs in for Donnell. Henderson wiping his shoes. Riley dumps off to Landon Cout. Cout gives off to Deshaun. Deshaun looking for someone to be open. Riley in the corner. It's the high pass. And the contested three by Darius Henderson misses. Here's Christian Ballaw with the defensive board. Christian driving up the left side of the court. Gives off to Darius Henderson. A little move in front of Landon Cout. And he makes the layup. So now just a hefty lead Pierce has got here. 71-47 with 8 minutes and some change to go. In this half. Centralia trying to get something started here. Aaron B. Richards looking for a lane, and the ball is swatted out of bounds by Christian Ballaw.
Time running down on Centralia. 7:55. Still have plenty of time, but gonna play better defense.
So Aaron B. Richards falls, but he ends up getting the ball to Ian Coates White. Deshaun trying to cook up something here. Gives off the Landon Cout in a three-point corner. Ian Coates working against Keelan. Keelan pushing him hard.
4 seconds on that shot clock.
Deshaun, deep three. Bang! Deshaun! That's a great shot by number one, Deshaun. Eventually, those three-pointers are going to fall.
Yeah, down by 21. 7:25 left.
Now here's Pierce's Joshua off to Keelan. Keelan to Christian Ballaw, guarded by Aaron B. Richards. Here's Cameron. Now Keelan has the ball back to Christian.
8 seconds on the shot clock.
Here's Christian. Excuse the fan behind me. And Christian with the right-handed lay. And now the Centralia Blazers are bringing the ball up with Deshaun. He crosses over Joshua, and the ball stolen. Right out of the hands of Deshaun by Darius Henderson. He's pumped up. He's excited. That'll end up being a foul on Darius.
Almost looked like a pretty clean strip, but
I think Deshaun had too much of a handle on that ball where I think the referee just noticed maybe Darius was getting a little too aggressive with that. So here's Landon Cout. Gives off to Deshaun, guarded by Joshua. Oh, nearly loses the ball there. Deshaun gives off to Ian Coates White or Bryson Williams, whoever's in the vicinity. Ian Coates White out of bounds. That'll be Pierce ball.
It's Pierce now with a 23-point lead. And they get the ball. Full court press by Centralia.
Now here's Cameron. Full court press given by Bryson Williams. Now Riley making it tough for Cameron. Get the ball out. Try to give it to Keelan. That'll be Pierce ball once again. And a timeout.
Timeout by Pierce, yeah. good decision by them. So they've got 6:30. They're up by 23. I think, you know, you're going to start taking longer possessions, taking some extra passes here if I'm Pierce, trying to wear that, just get the clock down.
You know, I think if Pierce were to just kind of run the clock out right now, you're right, it'd be a lot of pass-heavy offense, maybe run out the shot clock a lot before they even make the decision to shoot. Yeah. I think if Pierce were to comfortably coast from now on, as they've been doing so, is if they get to that 80-point mark, and from then on, I think they could really just kind of let the game run out by itself.
Yeah. You know, the problem with bringing just six players is if you have any injuries at all, you know, you're really in trouble. So it's kind of an interesting strategy.
All right. Here's Cameron. Gives it off to Christian. Christian to Darius, guarded by Riley McElraith. Now Cameron, guarded by Bryson Williams. Cameron trying to make something happen here. Here's Jeshua. Jeshua guarded by Nashawn. Nashawn playing some tough defense. There's a tiny screen by Keelan there. Now Cameron with the jumper at the buzzer. Trying to make something happen here. There's a head tap and a foul. So it'll be Centralia ball. Excuse me, no foul. That's just a run out on shot clock.
Yeah.
So now Nashawn bringing the ball up for Cameron. Against Cameron. Gives off to Landon Kaut. Kaut. Our survey the defense. Dumps it off to Riley. Riley gives off to Bryson Williams, guarded by Donnell. Donnell now in the game. Ian Coates-White in the post. Misses that right-handed layup. He gets the... Oh, he does not get the offensive rebound. Darius Henderson does. He drives up through the lane. The oop pass and the two-handed layup. The oop pass by Donnell Irvin.
Darius
25. Henderson. Now Bryson Williams. This is the three-point shot. And now Nashawn picks up the ball after a booted ball by Darius Henderson. Nashawn with the right-handed layup. And he makes it for the and one. Nashawn. Now Nashawn will head up to the three-point line. Spencer Gill in the game now for Riley.
Fourth foul on Deshaun. Or we'll see, what, 22? Yeah, Darius Henderson, that's his fourth.
Now Darius plays hard, and that's probably why he's got four right now. I mean, you can see how aggressive he is. He's the main big man for this team. Now here's Cameron, a small point guard. From Pierce. Oh, there's a foul. Bryson Williams. Oh, it's getting a little chippy now. Some extracurriculars happening between Pierce and Centralia. Bryson Williams showing he will not back down from the challenge. Jeshua stepping up for his teammate Cameron. You know, it's pretty common to see frustrations build like that. Down so much.
Right.
And you're not surprised when you see a little bit of scrappiness.
So you got to be careful, though, on doing things like that.
Right.
The refs are going to start calling it harder, so they'll pull him out of the game. It's going to be Bryson Williams. Just kind of pushed the player a little bit at the end of that play, and not a good decision to make.
I like what Coach Joe did. He didn't get in his face about it. He consulted him, said it happens. You know, I know that it gets chippy and we're down and it happens, but we're going to have you sit down and, you know, cool off for a little bit with 5 minutes to go here, just a little over. That'll be Pierce ball after the attempted rebound by Pierce. Darius yelling the sideline 5-5, which means position that Christian needed to be in. So we got some delay on the court. Jeshua taking up the ball. Yeah, tip by Nashawn, but no problem for Donnell. Donnell to Jeshua. Jeshua to Keelan. Keelan looking to Christian. Christian trying to get a play going on their half of the court. Here's guarded by Ian Coates-White. He's in the lane with a little jelly there, but seems to be fouled.
4:51 left. 76-52. We got Pierce at the line.
Foul on number 24, Spencer Gill. And Christian makes the first one.
Is it a timeout?
Must be a timeout.
So the, yeah, there'll be one more free throw after this timeout here, but refs kind of just consulting with each other. I think they've got to just be aware that, you know, we're down to under 5 minutes and they're a little chippiness out there. We don't want it to get out of hand.
Absolutely correct.
So 77-52. Really, we thought the strategy coming in would be to wear Pierce down, but that just hasn't happened. Pierce has made a lot of really good decisions as far as
right.
their passes and getting the ball around. And I think Centralia has had a lot of chances to get back into the game and just made some bad decisions as far as passes.
Right. It seemed like they're doing a really good job on the the back end of the first half where they were tying up the score, and then they were eventually down by three going into half. And I think the game just sped up a little bit on Pierce. But now Pierce is making Centralia play their game, which would be the slower game. Slow but aggressive is what I'd call it. Kevin calling the play, tapping his head. Christian guarding him. Kevin takes right, gives it off to Nashawn. Nashawn guarded by Keelan and Cameron. The right-handed floater makes it in.
It's a nice roll.
Now Centralia 54, Pierce 77. With Jeshua guarded by Nashawn. Christian guarded by Ian Coates White. Christian gives off to Keelan. Keelan gives it off to Donnell. Donnell looking for the three-point shot, and he barely misses an air ball. And he'll definitely hear it now from the student section as he walks slowly back.
So 4:10. Yeah, you can hear it there.
And I'm proud to say that those are my teammates. So, student section doing their work tonight. Centralia's Nashawn will bring the ball up. That's Cameron. And Ian Coates White with a contested three against Keelan. And the air balls. Christian Ballaw coming up with the ball. Nashawn guarding him. Donnell in the corner. Christian guarded by Bryson Williams to Jeshua. Jeshua to Cameron. Cameron driving through the lane. Dumps it off to Donnell. Donnell to Jeshua again. Jeshua to Christian. Christian to Cameron with a wide open three. Bang.
It's 80 there.
Centralia down plenty.
So
3:30 to go.
Pierce just getting those extra passes off. That's what they want to do, get the time run down.
Right. That's Nashawn with a nice little floater off the backboard. There's Cameras bringing the ball up, guarded by Nashawn. Calling plays. Cameron tries to shake Nashawn. Gives it off to Donnell. Almost picked off by Bryson Williams. Donnell to Jeshua. Guarded by sophomore Ian. Keelan driving towards the perimeter. Keelan. Now going towards the paint with a two-point jumper. Nice little lucky bounce. Now here's Nashawn.
Under 3 minutes left.
Nashawn comes in with the almost floater. Falling down floater. Jeshua's got the ball for Pierce. Pierce has a comfortable 82-56 lead here. 2:28 to go. Keelan, that pass was meant for Keelan, but it's picked up by Spencer Gill. Pierce trying not to wear themselves out, aren't running too terribly fast back on defense. That shot was blocked by Cameron.
Got a little bit of his arm there, so Landon Kaut will go to the line. 82-56 with 2:18 left. Wonder, you know, some of these players are where they're going to be heading off to next year, some of the sophomores. They're going to continue to play, or they're going to just go back to school.
Here's Landon Kaut, his first three-point attempt. And misses right, bangs off the right rim, right part of the rim. Joshua Forster will come in for Spencer Gill. And they're congratulating him on his last game. Coach Joe gave him a nice hug. He's high-fiving his teammates going down the line. Bryson Williams in the game as well. And Coach White with the putback. Make it 58-82 Centralia. Now some full court press here from Bryson Williams on Cameron. Cameron seems to shake it. Bryson catching up fairly quick. Here's Cameron. Gives it off to Christian, the law. Christian, Darius Henderson. Henderson to Williams. He'll be knocked out of bounds. So now Landon Kaut comes out of the game. His coaches are dapping him up. Give him nice hugs, give him a nice message. Hey, thank you for playing for these 2 years. We appreciate you. That's a great thing about these sophomores, man. They worked hard all off season. I remember we had the housing issue. The apartments weren't built yet, and we were all wondering and speculating, oh, when are we gonna move in, you know? And it'll be weird not seeing them around that much anymore, so.
Yeah, just 1:37 left in this game. And again, yeah, a lot of the sophomores, 6 sophomores their last game here for Centralia. Down 82-58.
Seems as Malachi Craig, freshman from Layton, Utah. Waiting to be checked in with Aaron B. Richards as well. So Ian will be subbed out. Once again, being congratulated by his coaches, other teammates. Number 34, Joshua Forster misses that free throw. It's picked up by Christian, excuse me, Christian Ballaw. Christian Ballaw letting the time run out. Number 44, Corbin Narone has checked into the game. Freshman forward, power forward, excuse me, from Utah. Just gets the block there. Bryson Williams takes up the ball. So minute and 12 left. Bryson Williams with a three-point shot. Misses wide. Here's Darius Henderson. Gives it off to Christian. Christian with the left-handed lay. Makes it to 84-59. Pierce. Time now running out in the milliseconds. Ashawn loses the ball to Cameron Williams. Now just going to foul. This is the time where they're going to sub in for the freshman who, did not get that much playing time this year. Classy move by Coach Joe. Teammates hugging Bryson Williams as he comes off the court. So Cameron Williams with these three-point attempts. Makes the first one. Drains it. Joshua Forster now coming off. Number 20 has entered the game. Danny Dahlstead. Freshman. He's from Onalaska, Washington. As well as Malachi Craig. Like I mentioned, from Layton, Utah. Danny Dahlstead loses the ball to number 23. And here's where they run the clock out. Cameron taking his time. Aaron not putting any effort into the defense. Waiting for the clock to run out. They're going to have to get a shot off. The shot clock and the game clock have not been synced up yet. And now here's a deep three by Donnell Irvin. And Malachi Craig almost came up with the ball, but Darius Henderson comes up with it. And with 5 seconds left, that'll be the last game for your Centralia Blazers men's basketball team.
For at least the sophomores and for this year, yeah. So 86-59. Let's get that written down here someplace. So. So let's see here. Second half, Pierce scored 52 points. And Centralia only scored 28 that second half. So Pierce had a three-point lead at the end of the first half. So
right. You know, that will do it, that point differential.
Yeah, definitely. So you see the players, some of those players know each other, so they're out there talking to each other. And so some may have gone to high school, you can check that. And then probably played against each other in high school too. So
yeah.
So not the outcome they want. They ended the season on a 12-game losing streak, but that happens sometimes, and you'll have a lot of sophomores next year on the team, so it should be a pretty good team when, you know, their second year coming back. And Pierce, let's see what they're at. They're at 11, they're 12 and 17. Centralia will end up at 6 and 22. And Grays Harbor is bottom in the league at 3 and 24 and 1 and 12 for the season. So, two good games tonight. Pierce coming away with both wins, but now usually they have a high school All-Star game. I'm not sure if we're doing that this year or not, but we may be doing that. And then that usually happens, I think, on a Friday night. So we may figure out, you know, with the old athletic director Bob Peters, he put that together. I'm not sure if they're going to continue that, but we may be bringing you the high school All-Star game sometime soon. And then we have baseball season coming up. You're playing on the team, though, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
So on those days where you're not playing, sneak up in the booth.
Oh, I wish. I wish. But, you know, as a bullpen guy, it's tough.
Yeah.
You don't know when you're going in. So.
Well, if there's any blisters on your hands and you're injured, you can always, you know, come up to the booth. And
I appreciate you, Mr. Fisher.
Yeah. So. All right, well, that's going to do it for tonight's game, the doubleheaders. And thanks. We want to thank you for tuning in to the Watterson Court.
Watterson Court, the Michael Smith Gymnasium.
Centralia College.
And there you go.
Pierce, or we should say Lewis County. So that'll be really the last basketball game, unless we have that, again, the high school All-Star game.
Right.
The final score was, let's get to that, 86-59.
Mm-hmm.
And Pierce only bringing six players, but able to withstand the onslaught of the Centralia College substitutions there. So thanks for joining us, and we will see you sometime soon.